Hello again.
Hello again.
Hi, Greg. If I don't see what this thing looks like today, I'm going to be very upset.
Like the actual hardware?
We need a price and we need to see what it looks like.
Yeah, those are two big points.
If none of that happens, then we don't care. then this was a wash.
I mean, you got like 4 or 5 months before it's supposed to come out. Like, when are you going to do it?
Yeah.
Maybe it'd be a big surprise when you open the box. That's when they reveal it.
That's what I'm saying. Who's the other voice, Bob? That's Greg. Lord Beardus. You're streaming too, right?
Yeah, I'm on it.
I think the multi still works. Just might have Jerry in there.
Yeah. Probably.
Where are we? Multi. Yeah, let me get rid of him. I also want to do a poll for what game I should play after this. I wanted to edit a video today, but instead we're doing this, I guess.
Thank you, Cassius Clay, for the follow. Appreciate it. What's up, Trevlin Steinberg? Trevlin Steinberg.
What? Oh, yeah, I wanted to do a... Let's call it poll.
I don't have a bot set up. I'll get a link.
Oh, this is not how you do a poll. Okay. Polls. Create a poll. Vote options. Maker 64. Warzone. All right. So here's so there's a poll active in the chat, I think. Please only vote in the poll if you're actually going to watch after the PlayStation 5 event. But anyway, if you're going to watch after the PlayStation 5 event, type in either Maker for Mario Maker, 64 for Mario 64, and I'm almost done. I will beat the game today if we pick that, and Warzone if you want Warzone. So far, 200% Maker. You know, I'll leave this up.
Yeah, I'm not going to hold my breath for Warzone.
Yeah, you're not going to get Warzone. Warzone's not going to happen. You don't have to exclamation point poll. You just have to type in the name of the game you want to see. And again, only vote if you're actually going to watch. I know half of you are big, fat, stupid liars. And again, if it's 64, I will beat the game today. I am at the very end of it. Hey, Atten. Thanks for the 13 months. Hey, Bob. Hello. To answer your question, I am streaming the reveal event. Jay Evans, thank you for the tier one. Molly Molly, thank you for the tier one. I'll leave this poll up while I'm you know, doing my thing.
Cassius Clay, does Jerry join?
Jerry is at work, believe it or not. He has a job.
He has a job. I'm going to work with him on the weekend.
Really?
Yeah. He like, awesome. Convinced one of the people there, like, hey, you want like an extra pair of hands?
That's
so
I'm going
to go there
awesome.
Saturday and Sunday, see how it goes.
So Jerry's on...
work the first time.
Jerry's on set on a reality show.
Yeah.
Doing PA work. Oh, God. Aiden just gave a whole bunch of stuff.
Warzone 25%. Come on, baby. We wanna, it's a new season, we gotta start playing it.
Alright, I made a command for exclamation point poll, but you don't have to use it. It's just to explain what the poll is. Mm. I will also add it to the title. Hey, Aiden, you bitch bastard. Thank you for the 5 gifted subs to Sleeping Toads, Thumpy Mike, Bot Stink, Box, Bot Stick, Beck 1694, and Calzone Zone. Oh, I didn't make my background blue.
Mm.
Got a few minutes left here.
Yeah, 6 minutes.
6 minutes. Should have put a timer on screen. Yeah, 64 and Maker is neck and neck. I'll remind you again that if it's 64, I will beat the game today. Warzone's engine up, baby.
Come on.
The problem is people are voting for Warzone. None of those people are going to actually watch me play Warzone. That's the problem.
Maybe. Maybe not.
Again, only vote if you're actually going to watch.
And I'm going to say, vote for Warzone whether you're going to watch or not. That's what I want to play.
Eric over here spamming Warzone, and he can't be stopped because he's a mod. But everybody gets one vote, you big dumb idiot.
The one thing I don't want to see for this little conference reveal thingy is I just don't want like a title to come up, be like all this music going on and then it's just like title of a game and then it fades out. Like, I don't want to fucking see that.
Oh, unless yeah
a game that's like completely out of left field. Like, I don't think I would ever see that game ever again, like a sequel to it. Like, if they just did like Metal Gear Solid, like, I would, my mind would blow. But if it's like Spider-Man 2 and it's only that, no gameplay, like, I don't fucking care.
You don't want just a title screen. You want,
yeah, it depends on the game. Like, if it's going to be like mind blowing, like, I guess for instance with Bethesda when they revealed Elder Scrolls 6, that was like, okay, good, this is like, this exists.
I'm, yeah, but exists. But Starfield, that's their other game. It's like, okay, I don't know anything, yeah, about this. Great, you're working on a game.
Yeah,
we all, like, knew, okay, you were.
I'm interested. I'd like to see it. Mm-hmm. Show us more, please. But, you know, that's what I don't want to see.
What's the command for photos of Bob Stoes? You just have to scroll through my Twitter. Guys, I got a serious question here. How long is a smoothie good for in the fridge? Got like 4 days on this guy. You think that's good?
I think that's fine.
It's fine.
Give it a sip.
Give it a sip? Maybe,
yeah,
a smell?
Give a sip. Yeah, give it a little. Is it wrapped?
It's wrapped in a
like
cellophane,
plastic,
yeah, plastic, yeah, wrap.
Oh, you're fine. Yeah, you're probably fine.
Chubby Fox said, like an hour. 50-50. You got like an hour. RGT over here eating leftover Taco Bell. You ever eat leftover Taco Bell, Greg?
Yes.
That's fucking gross. That is so,
you
know, gross.
You want an, I actually...
Dan, thanks for the 11 months. You want in the call? What are you doing, Dan? Where's AJ at?
I got a what's it called? shit, a quesadilla from Taco Bell from work. I bought two of them. I ate one, and then I wasn't hungry for the second one. So when I was going home from work, I threw it in the back seat. And then I forgot about it. I think it was like in the winter, so it was really cold out. It's like as if
so it froze it
in the fridge. Yeah, it just it kept it cool. I ate it. I went outside the next day and I put it in the oven and I ate it. It was fun.
That's horrible. Hi, Dan.
Hi. Let me tell you about this amazing omelet I had.
Oh my god. I haven't eaten. I basically just woke up.
I woke up and Alyssa ran to the store and got a bunch of stuff for omelets, and it was delicious. And I was told that if I didn't start with mentioning how great the omelet was, I'll never have an omelet again.
Where's AJ?
I have no idea. I thought he would be here.
I know. I didn't actually tell him I was doing this. I just kind of did it. But I assumed that he would see that I was doing it.
I saw you went live. I was like, I wonder if Bob wants me there or not.
Of course.
More
Dan,
the merrier.
Course. More the merrier. This, you know Greg. Have you met Greg?
I don't know if I ever met Greg.
We never really met, but you know, I see your name floating around all over the place.
Yeah, I think I watched you guys play some...
Warzone, probably.
Warzone, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which might be something that we're going to be doing right after this, Bob, from the look of it.
I don't know. Mario Maker's beating it out. Got 1% on it.
Oh, shit.
Should I vote?
You can vote, but only if you're going to stay and watch, Dan.
I have to put some notes in, but like, you know.
I have a video to edit today that I wanted to do, and instead I'm doing this. Life is a toilet.
Yeah, I mean, everything that today was supposed to be this morning has been thrown out the window, except for the omelet. The omelet was fantastic. Have I mentioned the omelet?
You like had a, everybody had a full day today.
Oh,
I rolled out of bed. I know how you know Greg, but how do you know Dan and AJ? I know Dan because a great wizard in a dungeon once. I met a great wizard, and the wizard said, "Hey, have you met my friend Dan?" And I said, "Hi, Dan."
Yeah, it was a really weird party.
No, I know AJ. Actually, I know AJ.
Was I meant to be here?
Oh, hello. There you are. I was like, I didn't tell AJ I was doing this, but he'll know. Oh, we're starting already.
I had no idea.
I didn't tell anybody I was doing this.
Bring forth the information.
I need to raise the volume here.
Atten told me.
Oh, there you go. I figured you'd see it.
Oop, I gotta get that away. There we go.
When do you guys speak?
Hello.
Oh.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay.
Wow, look how fancy that is.
Imagine that's what it looks like. Please just immediately show what it looks like. That would be great. Okay, it's an X.
It's a triangle. There we go.
You mean a polygon.
Whatever.
Oh my god.
Watch, it's all four of those, and you can just buy your favorite, so you can have the PS5 or the square PS5.
All right, get to it.
Wasting my time.
You ever wonder, like, different choices?
Internet's so better than mine.
Oh.
I like the hand with the dog.
Ah!
say I'm really kind of tired of these types of sizzle reels.
Yeah, we don't need this. We know the PS4 was great.
Yeah, you think that this dial with, well, never mind. I was about to say with live press conferences, but I forgot they still do those.
Why did I move here? I guess it was the weather. Or the, I don't know, that thing. That magic.
Okay.
I thought we was trying to get out of this bullshit.
Why are we doing this?
Why is this happening?
Why are we doing this?
More like a snee-eye, yes, every day.
Look at how great you were last time, guys. Look at how great.
We all remember. Did anybody forget Grand Theft Auto?
We should talk about work.
We out here gangbanging like it's 91.
Grand Theft Auto 5, remastered.
We all love banks.
Yeah, is this gonna be a launch title?
Or is this just a show backwards compatibility?
Give me a hand with these bodies.
Maybe they have some DLC for it. They never this actually did a single player DLC.
Well, in all fairness, the online's the more entertaining.
Was that Lawrence Sontag?
Just sort of smash things.
I think it was.
So now what?
Oh, yep. Yep. 2021? Not even a launch title. So, for the third time, you gotta buy it.
This is so stupid.
Oh!
Hey. Oh! Okay,
wait.
That's different.
Oh, at launch of GTA 5. So you don't actually get it at launch of the console.
And it's the PlayStation Plus one. I mean, in all fairness, GTA 5 is still one of the most popular games out there.
Yeah. Yeah, and they'll buy it.
It's kind of crazy.
Everyone will buy it a third time.
I want the triangle.
I wanted to look like the dev kit because everybody was saying it wasn't going to look like the dev kit.
It's definitely not going to look like the dev kit. I'll jump out this window if it looks like the dev kit.
I'll jump out mine too.
It was great to kick today off with a look back at just some of the seminal moments of the last 25 years. And what better way to bridge our past and our future than with a game that's graced every PlayStation console, Grand Theft Auto. It's been a privilege partnering with Rockstar Games for many years now, and we're thrilled to open today with
the news
that
that partnership
will continue with PlayStation 5. It's now just over a year since we began sharing technical details of PlayStation 5, but today's the day that we've been looking forward to for years, when we get to show you just some of the games that demonstrate our belief that PlayStation 5 marks the biggest generational transition our industry has yet seen. The content we've curated for today's event showcases how PS5 has inspired developers to create new experiences that are transformative in how they look, sound, and feel. Enough from me. We're going to have the games do our talking.
This guy cut this video together like a YouTube video. It's really bizarre.
I mean, it is a YouTube video.
I mean, you're not wrong, but...
All right, these are PS5 games.
Hero's just someone who doesn't give up.
Ooh!
Your dad said that.
It's looking a lot like Spider-Man.
Oh, that looks like a Spidey.
Now it's your turn.
It's Miles!
Go be a hero, Miles. Okay, let's do this.
Yo!
And he's web slinging.
Fighting me.
Ah, that's sick.
That's a good move.
That's great.
That's awesome. Holiday 2020. That's
I can't wait to play that for a few hours.
<笑>今日はまさに僕らが作っているグランツーリスモの情報をシェアできるということで、すごく興奮しています。今回のグランツーリスモはおそらくこれまでのグランツーリスモのファンの方がプレイしたら本当に嬉しいんじゃないかなっていう、キャンペーンモードを中心にしたグランツーリスモになっていると思います。ぜひ楽しみにしていてください。
Hi.
Is this guy CGI?
Oh. Are we doing Gran Turismo?
Yes.
That's what he said.
Clearly I was paying attention.
I'm sorry, AJ. I'm not good enough at Japanese.
I almost feel like all the speakers looked like they were CGI. Just look too...
Yeah, little did you know, all the speakers are actually in-game. That would be an insane twist to this entire thing.
Yeah, this was all real-time gameplay on the PlayStation.
That would be insane.
You could play the conference day one. You can be a developer. Executive.
Yeah, when? OMG. Gran Turismo 7,
this
when?
Marginally better.
This game's never coming out.
I'm surprised they started with a game that's new, well, after fucking Grand Theft Auto 5, and gave a window. Usually Sony's like, you'll get it when you get it.
Yeah. And it's actually very soon. That Spider-Man.
They did this event and was like, it's coming out eventually.
If this is a launch title, I will eat my hat. This is a weird trailer.
Yeah.
It's just, listen, more trailers need just straight gameplay, but this is the most boring game.
This is the one game that doesn't need the gameplay.
Yeah.
Turns out, it plays like a racing game.
Yeah, we just need 2 seconds of gameplay for a racing game to be like, all right, I get it. You got the speedometer. You could brake. You could turn.
Does anybody like playing
James.
Perspective?
James will get a PlayStation 5 just for Gran Turismo.
Oh, I don't mean... Gran Turismo is really, really popular, but I mean, like, playing it like this, because it seems like you're fucking yourself over playing it like this.
Oh, that's for simulation.
Yeah.
People do like playing it like that.
Oh, who are
those
you?
Those are people who get, like, the giant rigs and that, like, move like a car.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You do it with a controller.
And...
James used to play Grand Theft Auto in first person driving.
You all right back there?
Yo.
No, it appears that the dimensions are collapsing on one another.
No, it's not.
If we cannot
I love
get
me
to,
some. Wow. He is super shiny. The what the hell?
I mean, we can't be that far. I have it in my sight. They have found us, Ratchet. How do I steer this thing? Ask nicely. Slow down, please. That's not listening.
This looks freaking beautiful.
You can grind? I didn't know this was a spiritual successor to Sonic Adventure.
Well, it is certainly not good.
Ship, foul creature!
Ratchet. We are too late. Ratchet.
You can't separate them.
Who?
Ratchet's a Goryle?
It's a Garl.
Oh no.
Hi, I'm Marcus Smith, creative director at Insomniac Games. The entire studio is so excited to be able to share with you a first ever look at Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. A brand new
Ratchet
interdimensional adventure built from the ground up for the PlayStation 5. We're doing things we've never been able to do before. Like
Eric, I beat you to it,
Eric. Able to leap from planet to planet nearly instantly. Or put ray trace reflections on Clank.
There you go,
all
Dan.
All our alien worlds are filled with
ray-traced Clank
previously unseen.
Oh, hell
plus,
yeah.
Ratchet's
that's
all new arsenal
all
is
I ever wanted.
More exciting than ever, thanks to the DualSense controller's enhanced feedback. This game. Ratchet and Clank are near and dear to our hearts at Insomniac, and we can't wait to share more with you
in the
future.
He's not real.
But for now, here's another look.
He's also ray traced.
Everything's ray traced.
Did you see that?
Like my ride, bro? Off the long axe.
It's Ratchet and Clank!
Sand shots from above.
Will Ratchet and Ratchet meet in this game? And if they do, will they fuck?
I guess you'll just have to.
I guess I'll just have
to
throw down
out.
The 60 bones. You gotta buy the DLC for that.
Surface after all these years, just to try and take over the universe again.
Yeah! I kinda wish he was doing a worse job!
He must have more plans than
I've never played a Ratchet.
They're fun. I mean, it's the whole premise was it's all about blowing shit up. So, if you like doing that.
I don't understand what it's doing.
It's basically like a grappling point. Because he's just teleporting around the field, so it's just a grappling hook that's a little neater.
So when he goes into that rift, is he just coming back out on the opposite side of the room?
Basically. Oh.
I thought it was like a different dimension thing from the... I mean, from the name? And also from the like little target render at the beginning.
Yeah, I mean, that's just what I could tell. Are we gonna see it now?
Yeah, just show me the console, dude, and give me a price.
$2.
Too steep, dude. Tell me when it's 125.
You got it.
Oh. Oh shit! Final Fantasy VIII.
That would be ridiculous.
They got vans in Final Fantasy?
They do not.
There's no vans in 15? There's gotta be at least one.
Oh, well, there's
no. I mean shoes.
Oh. Well, also those.
Okay, I know nothing about that game.
Designed exclusively for PlayStation 5.
Dan, tell Alyssa thank you for the emote.
Oh. Hey, Alyssa. Bob says thank you for the emote.
Why? Chicory.
It came up on my phone.
No, he just told me to do it. Yeah, no, he's, he did it now.
Ask him which one he wants next.
Well, that will wait till after the stream. Look at all these DOS robots.
And cats. Greg, this is your game.
And cats.
I love cats.
My oh my god, do you play as the cat? Please tell me you play as the cat.
Why would robots keep cats around?
Cats are keeping the robots around.
That's the trick.
That's it.
Cat is gonna fucking murder the robot.
Cats are all planning to take over the world.
Okay.
Oh my god, you play as the cat?
Alright.
To get it.
Okay.
Look up Stray when you're done.
2021.
Shitty console. Canceled.
Canceled buying Xbox and boxes. Two Xboxes.
Alright, dude. Get it. Unless the PlayStation 5 is a triangle, a circle, or an X. Or square, I don't give a fuck. Stop showing me.
Just 4K show Ultra HD.
Okay.
It has 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray.
Oh shit.
And an ultra high speed SSD, which we knew already.
They really wanted you to know about that SSD.
Ray tracing.
Buzzwords you can use against your fellow fanboy friends.
That's actually a pretty cool animation. But it's yeah. The bitrate is not having a good time on Twitch.
No.
Particles are not doing good. Now look at all those holes. Yeah. 3D audio. Can I still use my frickin' earbuds?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's advised. Listen to Mark Cerny, dude.
I can't. I can only listen to him for like 15 minutes at a time.
Making games used to be about these constant trade-offs between the artistic vision.
This guy is fake. This guy is 100% fake.
PS5, we're not going to be burdened like that. We're going to be able to realize our artistic vision a lot better.
Dude, this guy's fake as shit, dude.
It's got a ton of horsepower, which is very easy to unlock, and it's a machine that's really easy to develop on. The PS5 will present a paradigm shift as to what players will come to expect from gaming. Will let us tell stories, make worlds, create gameplay that I think will truly captivate the player and really surprise quite a few people.
Please take a look at this new franchise
from Hollywood Studios coming exclusively for PlayStation 5.
He does look kind of fake, though.
He looked fake.
I think I'm overthinking it, but like, it didn't look right, right?
I mean, they're shooting him at 60 frames.
Yeah, but 60. I
actually, no, 30.
It's a Housemarque game, so.
No, this stream is in 30. I forgot they announced that the stream was going to be in 1080p 30.
Oh, yeah, true.
Attack. My death. The crash. The attack. My death. Trapped in this endless cycle. Even death is no escape. Each time I awake, this planet seems somehow different, as if changing. This world.
What is this, Star
is
Wars?
Part of me.
Isn't that what's that? Tom Cruise movie where he goes through this over and over again.
Oh, right.
I spend here. slip away. But I cannot lose hope. My only choice is to keep fighting.
Edge of Tomorrow, that's the movie.
To keep looking for answers. My only hope is to break the cycle. Before the cycle breaks me.
I think this,
that's a stupid name.
Returnal? That's a Kojima name.
I think this was the developers of Dead Space.
It was Housemarque. Housemarque is like Resogun and like that type of shit. So this is like a fucking, this is a left turn for them.
I didn't pay attention to the opening thing.
Sumo, Sly Cooper, 6.
Tony the Tiger. Oh no, what? Basketball?
Oh no.
You bought blank.
Oh, Little Big Planet.
Okay, you're activating the furries. Sackboy, A Big Adventure.
Not even called Little Big Planet? Feels like a
miss. Is it full 3D?
It's a
full
3D. Oh, so this is freaking Little Big Planet 3D world. Yeah.
I like this.
I'm down.
You don't even like 3D worlds.
Bob, do you not like 3D world?
It's not that I don't like it. I just think it's one of the weaker Mario games.
That's the PR way. I fucking hate the game. The game sucks.
What's this band? I know this band. It's the same band that did the original soundtrick. Or the original song, the main song.
Band, dude.
Good old big.
He's hideous.
How dare you? Everybody's beautiful under.
Except for her. This is 3D world, dude.
Yeah, it is. It's 3D world, but a big planet.
I too am.
So are we not making our own levels? Is that what's happening?
I still hope you can do that, because that's kind of like the big part of the draw, right?
Yeah.
Probably not.
Well, they made did they make Dreams?
That's why they avoided adding the Little Big Planet.
They did make Dreams. Yeah, they're too busy making Dreams. What the Fongaloop is this? The Go Team! That's the name of the band that did that song.
Oh yeah, I like them.
They're very good.
Characters look like we're trying way too hard to make these edgy,
iconic,
cool skins. Like,
I don't understand the game. Are you in the car? Are you out of the car? Why would you ever want to get out of the car?
Yeah, maybe your car gets fucked and you gotta, then you're out of your car and you gotta try to find a new car or a way to fix your car.
It's man versus car.
We call it Man versus God.
Destruction All-Stars. All right, man. Okay, dude.
All right, that told me nothing.
Not as bad a name as Returnal, but.
That's a George Lucas name.
Hello, everyone. My name is Josh Greer.
I mean, in all fairness, it's good to know they have
Ember Lab,
a bunch of games
team
coming
with
out.
A background in film and animation.
It's true. And we're very excited today to share with you the first look at our new game.
No dates in 2021.
It's a story full of adventure and charm that has themes in personal growth.
Look how fake these guys are.
I'm so still looking.
They're CG. Do you think it's the lighting?
Yes.
Maybe the lighting is fake.
And they're being shot in at least 30.
I know. Those things are hideous too.
You sense the power that flows through this land. Yet you do not fully understand it. Driven by the belief that you can help these troubled spirits. But you cannot hide your weakness from me. You have no power here.
Pikmin.
Smile. She hates that thing.
Pikmin of the Wild.
It's Pikmin Zero Dawn, dude.
You can forget that.
Oh my fucking god, I'm tired of that.
I know, just let's just bust through all of these. Some of us don't have the 5 second bumper time.
You ever feel like you're just waiting for a sign?
Ew.
Pizza.
There's anchovies on one of them.
To do that thing you've always
gross.
Meant to do. Sometimes
ew.
I feel like I'm
there's always at least
on
one hideous thing in everything.
I was gonna say, hey, Jay, what do you think of that one?
But something's holding me back.
Whoever
maybe
designed this game definitely played a lot of Neopets.
Maybe it's the fear that...
What if it is a Neopets game?
I'd lose my mind.
When I'm still just standing on the edge. But if
this,
we've got nothing...
This so seems like the perfect... Like... Evolution of Neopets.
Yeah, the natural evolution.
Yeah, those people who grew up and now they're into this stuff.
Oh, it's a fucking okay. Yeah, this is the Neopets game.
Is this how the dinosaurs died?
Game's called. All right. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. That's how it. They're all gonna die.
Oh my god.
Spoiler, sorry.
What a, I don't know. That's weird. I don't like that.
There's a precursor to Neopets and they fucking died.
I don't like that at all. That's weird. That makes me feel weird.
Hi, I'm Lorne Lanning and I'm here to share.
No, you're not. You're
game
fake.
I've been dying. It's an emotionally engaging story where rescuing
Awkward.
Is rewarding.
My name
failure
is Lorne Lang. I'm a real person.
And the memories should last you a lifetime. Take a look.
I am a human man.
You believe me, right?
The big twist to this entire thing is PS5 was created entirely by AI.
You are no longer a slave, Abe.
Yo. Trend continues.
trusted, followed, and it led them here. You may have escaped the murderous blades.
Oh, it's the, one of Thanos' children.
Your entire people is up to you.
Well, I know Kid Icarus is losing his mind right now.
These guys haven't developed anything besides this, right?
Yeah.
You must find your full voice.
Yep, they just do Oddworld.
Soulstorm.
PlayStation 5 によって我々の考える東京のビジュアルを実現できました。
I'm starting to think these guys are real because they made too many models.
これからお見せするのはゴーストワイヤー東京の世界初のゲームプレイ動画です。スーパーナチュラルでミステリアスな東京、そこに潜む脅威と美しさを感じ取っていただけると思います。
Was it E3 last year that they showed Ghostwire?
I think it was the year
before. Who now?
Ghostwire. It's, you know that...
Yeah, her game.
It's spooky.
But I don't know how much she had to do with it, because she, like, quit.
Yeah, she got...
Right after that.
I think she got booted. I don't think she quit.
You see things...
She got booted? No, I think
she
quit.
She made the game.
I think they ousted her.
Why?
Oof. Big oof.
Hear threats. Others don't.
She was the art director.
I think she was just the straight up director for this game. The past she was.
Let's get a name here. Won't. It's like Icky something.
It's up to you to save Tokyo.
Ikumi Nakamura. Creative director, art director. Pre-pro consultant, former Aperture Science member. So probably creative director. She was creative director and art director.
Can you imagine not seeing the ghost?
I don't understand how a game...
It is spooky.
Is it supposed to be like fear? You know, it's got the supernatural element to it.
I actually missed the entire trailer because I was looking up Ikumi Nakamura.
I don't get how a horror game could be a horror game if it gives you the power to fight back. Then it's not scary.
And it's just jump scared, man. I mean, Dead Space, though.
It has to make you feel helpless, at least for part of it.
Well,
like the last arc.
100% creepier.
The hell am I looking at?
Super Brothers.
Oh, Super Brothers? The Sword and Sorcery EP people? That's literally the only thing they've made.
Mm-hmm.
concurrence on Twitch.
Play as a rocket.
Okay.
Oh, it's a planet sperm. We're impregnating the planet.
A lot of weird stuff going on. A lot of weird games.
Yo, holiday 2020, dude. More X's.
Boo! Boo, Gearbox, boo!
Make way for the King of Kings for a long stretch, no limousine. If you're the one that's gotta intervene, I'm the biggest one of those you ever seen. I'ma need a crown. I'm the only one that ever held it down at the tip top. People flip flop every day, not I top five. I'm a big shot. I'm the one that wanna take the big shots, big balls, big rings, big rocks. Look at me now, count me down. So give me the crown. Make way for the king.
I hate this trailer. Mm-hmm. Like, I just do not like it.
Oh, I knew about Godfall.
Are we gonna play with this music?
Yes, it's definitely not the soundtrack. It's not even anywhere close to what the soundtrack's gonna sound like. That's a launch title, I think.
Cool box.
It's also weird that they're giving holiday, you know, windows. Like, yeah. If they're gonna announce the date, just announce it in the beginning.
That's a telltale sign that they're not going to.
Oh, wait. These are the guys who did Hyperlight Drifter.
Yeah.
Heart Machine. And this is looking very Hyperlight Drifter-esque.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it seems pretty on brand.
Oh, damn.
Did they go 3D Zelda? What?
Oh, Breath of the Wild intro.
So Hyperlight Drifter was like A Link to the Past-esque? Did they just go straight to Breath of the Wild? What happened?
Where did the rest of it go?
Good.
It was always gonna end like this. All your hard work, all your sacrifice, only sped up the process.
So pessimistic, dude.
Oh,
yourself alone.
Yeah!
Control 2.
Are those people presenting?
Awaits.
Oh, my OBS disconnected. God damn it. Oh, god damn.
Hakan Abrak here from Ion Interactive. In Hitman 3, Agent 47 is back for his most intimate and professional contract in his entire career. This is also the dramatic conclusion for the World Assassination trilogy. I'm so proud to be here to present a little glimpse of the gameplay where Agent 47 is on top of the world in Dubai. Enjoy.
I have still never played a Hitman game. Oh.
Me neither. Now that I think about it.
This won't be where I start, so move to the next game.
This seems right up my alley. I like stealth games. Will likes these games. I left the I left my stream audio on by accident. Sorry.
Oh, now we get to see the OS.
Nope.
Are you kidding me?
Nope, just a little tease for you, Dan.
Oh, good. Great.
I mean, listen, games are probably the most important. But I would like to see what the console looks like, and I would like to see the UI and everything. Oh.
I don't know what this is, but it looks neat.
What the fuck?
Wow.
This happens.
This is a very interesting art style.
Yeah. What are those desert penguins? And how?
Schmeet.
What? What is this game? Fuck.
This looks amazing.
I like it. I'm in.
This is so
It's weird, but there's something really charming about this.
Little devil inside. I'm down for that. That looked freaking awesome.
I'm very confused by it, but I'll try it. 2022. Did you give a date?
What's up, everyone? I'm Zion Williamson of the New Orleans Pelicans. Here we go. The first ever teaser for NBA 2K21.
Even he looks fake, but he's remoted in.
Also, he sounds very fake, too.
Well, he sounds like he's in a...
I don't mean like audio-wise, I mean how he's speaking.
Yeah. Oh.
Willow Davis, thank you for the raid. I ain't trying to break you down, but for real, you might as well give up now. Think you got a chance, but I don't see how. Got a real tight grip when I hold that crown. I'm the first one in and the last one out. Whoever owns the place gotta drag me out. That's how you know it's next or gen. Sweat. You better just how you know? That, what a weird trailer. Just one guy.
Damn.
Yep.
You have to see the sweat, though, so that's how we know that the graphics have been.
They spent all their time making all the presenters, so, you know, only one basketball player.
That's true.
Man, it's a lot of freaking games. Like,
Animal Crossing 2!
What?
I don't know. Stop.
What?
Kid, stop. Stop. Sony, please. It's gotta stop.
Amazing. Aren't they? Half by Amazing.
A very recently discovered. Is that a cheeseburger?
Is this a fake Australian accent?
Oh, this one's lively. Beautiful seed patterns.
What the fuck?
What is happening?
Welcome to the Island of Bug Snacks.
Ah, Octodad, it all makes sense now.
No.
What's that? Were they ribs? What?
I hate this. I hate this so much.
The song is great.
What did she say talking about bug stuff?
Bug snaps? Snacks. Bug snacks.
My invitation is open.
No, don't stop
me
it.
On the island of bug snacks.
Stop eating the food.
Liz, I was trying to carry a lamp with my weenie hands, but I dropped it and now the town's on fire.
Oh, again? It's bug snacks.
With an X.
So you know it's cool.
But what is the game?
It's about the game. It's a horror game, dude.
Oh, apparently. What's a launch title?
I hate it. I have such a like.
Octodad was one of the best games of year one of the PlayStation 4. Okay, buddy.
That's fine, but I do not.
Octodad came out before the PlayStation 4 did.
Did it?
I think so. I think it was a PC game first.
Oh, that doesn't count. That doesn't count. Oh, Octodad came out on PC, but then there was Octodad Dadliot's Catch, which was the sequel.
Yeah, I thought that was like the definitive.
It was a completely different game. If you look at the original Octodad, it looks way different.
To the end of the show,
I know Shuhei's a real guy.
I have something very near and dear to me.
Is it Bloodborne 2? If it's not, then
it's Patapon.
Get the fuck out.
It's Patapon.
Yeah, Patapon.
It's Greg Miller, Patapon. The game.
Greg. Be Greg Miller. Play as Greg Miller.
Oh, it's Horizon 1 Dawn.
AJ. Devil May Cry 7. Oh.
Oh.
What? Dark Souls 4?
Bloodborne 2.
Very confused.
Oh. Demon Souls 2. Or remastered or whatever.
Oh, no. Demon Souls 2.
Where's the 2?
No. Yeah, there's no,
no
2.
Right, just
remastered. Yeah, Blue Demon Point Souls is definitely what? Remastered.
So everybody thought it was friggin' Bloodborne.
Same shit, honestly.
Then they just pull 180 and it's Demon Souls.
Assassins locked in the
That's
time.
Crazy.
This is our unique vision, what Arkane is all about.
Freeform immersive gameplay, a surreal player-driven story smashed together.
Want to see some stylish action? Check this out.
Wait, is this Assassin's Creed gameplay? So everybody can be like, oh, dude, yeah, this is definitely better than the Xbox thing.
Hello, Black Reef. Cold, my predecessor, has been pronounced guilty of treason. He is to be shot on site and forth in perpetuity. Your assistance is appreciated.
Oh, this didn't we see this?
The real party doesn't start until
last
day.
She is not making this easy.
Check this out.
But isn't this like game where you're playing as two different sides or something? I feel like I remember seeing this.
I don't know this at all.
I just remember the big circle thing.
It's cold!
Hope you're ready to loot! Already.
Looks a lot like Dishonored.
Busted. Some Bioshock vibes.
It's Team Fortress 3.
Yeah, Bethesda.
Oh, that's where I remember. Morning, it was from Black Bethesda. Reef.
Another day, another death. Our time loops fun. For everyone else on this island, this place is paradise. A never-ending party where hunting me is the main attraction. And no matter how I try to escape, they always cut me down. But I'm one stubborn motherfucker.
Dang.
How fucked up
every loop I'm learning a little more, piecing together the puzzle.
Seems like an arcane game.
There's eight targets, and they all gotta die before midnight. There's just one little snag.
I think it's arcane.
You thought it was going to be easy?
Juliana Blake, Black Reef's protector, and a real pain in my ass. She may kill me a million times. But eventually, inevitably, I will break this fucking loop.
I like this idea. This is a cool concept.
Watching you die. I like killing you. There's a difference.
Is that a multiplayer aspect? Okay. It's been an hour, dude. Like, I'm
really excited about all these games, but I also got a bunch of other shit I gotta be doing right now.
I'm currently editing a video.
Oh, Kingdom Hearts 4. Long ago, a young girl went with her mother. I'm just calling her.
I'm just like, what? What are you?
I don't know. It's just, if there's text on the screen, I immediately go Kingdom Hearts.
Slender Man.
But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence. The bush is empty. Nah, Kingdom Hearts 4, I was right.
George Washington. The rascal broke
free from his grasp. Abraham Lincoln.
Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran. He already had his turn. Got a movie, George Washington gets a game. And into the forest.
Yeah. I mean, Hamilton got a. What is it with that creepy story? Got a Tony Award winning Broadway play, so you know.
Yeah, and a rap album.
Yeah, a rap album. Quit being so paranoid.
No, no! Friendly! Friendly! Oh, frame
rate. God damn, he shot this man frame one.
Frame rate is messed up.
Yeah. They're coming. Who is? Too much ray tracing.
A lot of ray tracing. Especially in the dark, dude. Hardest place to trace rays.
The editor that put the trailer together accidentally did 12 frames per second.
Everyone's telling me to turn off the volume. No, it's the trailer's fault. Volume's been fine. This trailer's quiet for some reason.
It's a baby.
What the hell is this?
Washington.
Man. George Washington had a hell of a past. When does this take place?
Village.
1976.
Oh!
Oh!
Take that!
Chris?
Oh!
Why?
Holy shit!
Whoa!
That was awesome.
What a fucking twist.
I was like, Village is a terrible name.
Yeah, I was gonna be like
George Washington in Resident Evil.
That was freaking cool.
Your commitment to the bit never fails. Just to blow me away.
It's my thing, dude.
It is your thing. It's your bit.
Exactly.
Hi. What you doing?
Is this a Dead Space situation?
This is a current events.
Yep.
What's happening right now?
Division 3, dude.
Man, Division made a real hard turn.
Those are some JRPGs eyes if I've ever seen it. Japanese developer, I'm calling it.
I, cause the cat, that's racist.
No, cause the giant rounded eyes, that's why. Also the cat.
When did that happen?
Blame the little girl. It's always the little girl's fault.
Oh,
What?
She's a magical demon child, and the world wants her gone. And the spaceman is trying to help her.
Pragmata.
What is that?
What?
You're on the moon.
Our freedom.
She's on the moon without. Yep, she's a demon child.
I have a lot
of
questions.
She's a robot.
Capcom.
Same thing.
It said Capcom on the bottom.
There you go.
2022.
I don't care. Do what? Just loop them all together.
MG's the P, the S.
I just want to know what the freaking thing looks like and the price. I'd rather know what it looks like more than the price, honestly.
I never thought I'd be upset at all about game trailers.
I know. Usually it's like, just show us the games, but dude, it's been over an hour right now.
I just don't need the interstitials. I don't need to know how good your fucking After Effects guys
the
are.
Ones.
Yeah, screw them. I'm better.
Ended this whole thing.
They're great cities.
I actually, guys, spoiler. This was all me. I hope you enjoyed.
Did you render all the speakers too?
No, this is Finding Nemo 3, dude.
Came new life.
Horizon One Dawn.
Oh, well, there you go.
Craziest crossover.
I must find
ever.
A way to stop it. Or it will get worse and worse.
Is that in the Pokemon DLC?
It destroys us all.
The most. Legendary crossover of all time.
There's nothing I wouldn't do to save this world.
Yeah, man. Marvel ain't got nothing
no
on that.
I won't explore.
Can go in the sea.
No secret.
This game
I
was them
being.
Well, I'll let you climb your shit. I'll let you go underwater. Fuck them.
No barrier. I won't cross. This mission is mine alone. If I falter, if I fail, there won't be anyone left to stop what's coming.
Horizon right. 2.
I want it to be called the Horizon 1 Dawn.
Zero 1 Dawn.
Or comes. Horizon Zero Noon, as the chat says.
Game ends at midnight.
Horizon Zero Dawn is a dumb name. That's like it's like when you're coming up with a band name and you just pick a bunch
of words. On behalf
of
the entire team at Guerrilla, we're happy to share the first look at Horizon Forbidden West.
We're continuing Ellie's story as she moves west to her far future America.
To brave a beautiful but dangerous frontier masked with mysterious new threats.
Get ready
she's
going to
meet George Washington.
Distant lands ravaged by
George Washington's
storms.
In the
and
east.
Take on new, powerful machines as you return
to the majestic world of Horizon.
Stay tuned for much more. We can't wait for you to get your hands on it.
I can't wait either to play your first game.
Yo.
I think there's a lot to look for.
This is it.
The community.
They do the whole community thing
as a game
for like
designer,
a few minutes.
Storyteller, this is incredibly exciting.
And then they show us the console and the price.
No, they showed their one black guy.
New experiences like we've never had before.
Where is he? Where is he? Where is he? It's taking a while to get there.
We want to wow players.
Expect the unexpected.
And I, for one, can't wait.
Never put him on the screen again.
It's so exciting.
Incredibly exciting.
It's really about
love.
As a developer, that's an amazing feeling to have.
Wow.
Is there really not a single black guy? Oh, there he is.
No, they showed the one black guy.
Oh, it's balls.
Imagine it's just phloem. It's made out of phloem.
It's just phloem.
Is it also a tower?
Show us. Show us.
Yes, we get it. You're very good at making shapes. We've noticed that the entire time. There's the X's.
Please be flat so I can put stuff on it.
Oh, this is Big Hero.
Please be flown.
The balls are creating.
I will not accept this. Yeah, I will not accept this console unless it is flown now.
Imagine after all this, we don't get to see what it looks like.
See you, holiday
2020. Uh-oh.
When you open the box.
Uh-oh, that looks a little bit like the dev kit.
Yeah, it looks a little
I'm telling you, dude. As soon as I saw the controls,
oh, there we
like,
go.
Yeah,
all right.
Like
okay.
All right.
Oh.
Yeah, their thing's also towered, PC tower-esque.
Oh, yeah. Is it going to be curved on all sides? Can I lay it flat? Please let me lay it flat. Okay, the bottom's flat.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Good, good, good. All right, well, this is a better form factor than the Xbox Series X. I can put it on my desk.
Yeah.
Andrew.
Yeah, it looks about the size of a 4 Pro. Oh, the bottom's not flat.
Looks like just a more rounded PC tower.
Why do they all gotta be towers?
They share one brain, dude. One singular brain.
How much?
Oh! Oh, it's just a discless version.
Oh.
Okay, alright. I was about to lose my mind. Wow, the disc really juts out.
Yeah. If I'm gonna be honest, I kinda wanna go with the discless.
Yeah, the discless is a lot cooler.
Depends
That's actually
much...
really cool that it's smaller without the disc.
Depends
That's cool.
It is. If it's like $100 cheaper, I'm down. But if it's
not... Yeah, yeah.
I bet you it won't be cheaper, it'll just have more storage.
Not cheaper, I don't want it.
But more storage though.
We hope you've enjoyed.
I'd like having the option to spend $20
today.
Less on games.
You've seen our most striking
hours.
Console design yet, and you've seen games that can only be enjoyed with the full range of PlayStation 5's features and power. At PlayStation, we believe in generational transitions.
Okay, but how much?
And we put years of work into making them happen. We want you to enjoy the unique benefits
house.
Of moving from
My Twitter's
one generation
going nuts
to the next.
Right now.
Thank you for joining us.
Oh,
we're launching later
nuts.
This year, and we
no
have
price,
tons more to share.
Yeah, no
Welcome
price.
To PlayStation 5.
No
price.
No price. Guaranteed.
Come on.
If you saw the plastic box, dude. I'll get asked.
$2. $2.
At least $3.
At least.
Not wrong. You're not wrong.
I will be
for whatever Horizon comes, it'll be $300.
I got a deal for you, Sony. Give me $15 and I'll play your PlayStation 5. Sound good?
Look.
I missed the meteor.
You're gonna want to take that deal.
Man, I'll even take $10 if it's the Disney version.
Ooh, man, you gotta take that deal. It's AJ. He turned on the PlayStation 4 three times last year.
I wanted Warzone as a launch title. I'm a little upset.
Not one Call of Duty at all.
Not one Call of Duty.
Not a single Call of Duty. I didn't see any more.
Oh,
it's a lot of Pikmin, some Zelders.
Hideous fucking Neopet
snacks.
Missing links.
$2.99.
Imagine $2.99. That would be insane.
That would be absolutely
$5.50 is what I'm saying.
Yeah, I can get on.
€6. Like $400.
Are those all accessories?
Play has no limits now. That's crazy.
Except for your wallet.
No price. Oh,
come on.
Yeah, it's no priceless, price. Dude. It's priceless. We're selling our identity to them.
Say that to my bank account.
Ah, dude. Just gonna let you have it on good faith that you'll buy at least 2 games per month.
There were a lot of great games there, I would say. I mean, there were a lot of games. So at least some of them have to be good, you know?
I wasn't going to buy it. I saw Spider-Man. I'm down with buying it now. Well, I wasn't going to buy it at launch, but...
That looked like a launch thing, right?
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
That's wild.
Show me some launch shit that I want. I'm buying it. That's all I wanted. Last gen, they did not do that for me. This gen they did.
That's awesome. I mean, I was always gonna get it when it came out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now you gotta fucking find a place for it. I've only flat space.
It's way too weird looking. I don't.
Right.
I mean, I like how it looks.
Same thing. They did the same thing.
I like how it looks. I don't like how it's gonna fit in my life. Like,
that's fair.
Like, it's a tower and from the side. No, it's rounded. Yeah, you can't lay it flat. Or maybe you can, it just might have some space underneath it. I don't know. Also, I wanted to go all digital in the next generation, but I don't know if I do anymore, because all these games are gonna be massive. And
probably not, though. That's the thing. And I was trying to tell you that the whole time. And
I gotta listen
to Mark Cerny, dude.
I got a gigantic comment that was like a book about how I'm wrong, that the next gen games are gonna be massive.
Probably. I don't know if they're gonna, because a lot of people are like, they're gonna be smaller. They're probably not gonna be smaller. They're probably gonna net out to be about the same, because a lot of the like space in game file size is repeated assets, and they don't have to do that anymore for a couple of reasons, where it's like the SSD can access the memory faster, blah blah blah, and then also stuff in like Unreal Engine 5, that shit. So I don't think that they're gonna, like, it's not gonna balloon like it did from standard definition to HD to HD.
But it ballooned from the beginning of the PlayStation 4 life cycle to now.
Yeah, because games got better, but the tech that is driving them didn't. Mm-hmm. Whereas now the tech exponentially got better, and the games are still more or less the same as they were on PC. So like, if you look at games on PC, like their file sizes, they're more or less the same because they have the same type of hard drives. There's no like mass consumers, like, most consumers don't have NVMe M2 drives in their PCs, so games are not built to use them.
I think games are still going to be like over 100 gigs each.
Yeah.
For like the main, you know, the big stuff, like Horizon and like, you know, Spider-Man. I think you're going to be looking at
500.
Yeah, Call of Duty's going to be insane. I think you're still going to be looking at updates that are like massive. And if they're, even if they're the same as they are
I definitely don't agree that the updates are going to be bigger. I think if anything, the updates are going to be significantly smaller.
I mean, when you get the game and you put it in the console, it's going to have a day one update and it's going to install all the stuff on it. All of that is going to be a lot.
Yeah.
Even if it's the same as it is right now, that's still too much. Because these hard drives are going to be a terabyte. We need... If I'm going to have this console for 5 years, I need more room. I'm not going to be able to do it all digital.
I don't think that they look at hard drive space in the same way that like you do, where it's like you want to have all your games on your hard drive at all times. I think they're thinking like, as long as there's enough for people to have the games that they're going to be playing on their hard drives, then it's fine.
Yeah, of course. But that also means that I can't get the digital the all digital version because I want to keep everything. And I buy a lot of games, so it just would never happen. And I can't,
and
just
you're
probably
not going to be able to get external drives either, to be honest.
I mean, it's got USB plugins. They got a USB-C.
No, you can.
It
has
USB-C, but is that fast enough?
So
the NVMe M2 speeds.
They said you can plug in external hard drives, but they're just for storing the game. You would then dump the game onto the NVMe. So you need to have room on the NVMe for games that you want to play currently, but then you offload them onto an external drive.
It offload it temporarily, or do you have to be like, all right, these are the five games I want to play, I'm storing them on this hard drive?
I think it's got to be
The games off of the external drive.
Yeah, so what's the point?
Somebody like me who wants to store the games so that they always
like the
have them,
we're never going to play again, then to put them on the external hard drive.
Yes.
I don't know, like, I'm looking at Twitter right now, and just there's no in-between on the design of this. You either freaking love it, or you're like, kind of looks a little weird.
It looks like a spaceship.
I think it just looks like a gaming PC, and that's boring. IMO.
It looks like an alien.
But I don't think it looks good or bad. It just looks like a gaming PC, and whatever.
I think it looks good, but I think it could be more functional. Like, again, it doesn't look like you could put it on its side, and if you can, there's gonna be space underneath it. I do like how there's a discless version that is smaller. I think that's really cool.
Yeah, I mean, maybe the whole point is if you can put it on its side, the idea is to get it so the point of contacts are less. So I don't see any fans on the bottom. It all seems to be in the middle. So never mind, my point is completely invalid. Thanks for sticking with me for that.
And all that shit. No prices on anything.
Be a good sign.
Yeah, no. I mean, honestly, seems like the beginning of Switch, where everybody freaked out after they revealed the prices for the stuff that they showed and didn't show the prices for in the presentation.
I was honestly expecting,
we're like, the dock is this much, and you know that shit.
I was honestly expecting a press release after this to show a price. Even if they didn't show it in this video.
If that is something that they do, the price is fucking astronomical. That's the only reason why I could ever see them wanting to, like...
Maybe they don't know yet.
Maybe just sitting and waiting to see what Xbox does.
Anyway, I have a poll here. You just type in 64 Maker or Warzone in the chat if you want me to play one of those games. Right now, Maker is winning, but only by a little bit. And only vote if you're gonna stay.
I voted, but I'm gonna leave now.
You're a piece of garbage.
Oh, this has been fun.
Man.
Everybody only gets one vote too, so if you vote, if you keep spamming votes, Greg voted first Warzone.
Fucking traumatized me with hideous creatures.
You know,
they leveled out towards the end.
Yeah, I do think that the major takeaway is that there will be X's, maybe some squares, couple triangles, and a butt ton of circles.
Yeah, man. Can't wait to press on the circle button, dude.
Do they have do they have a video of it?
What do you mean?
like the final montage.
Like the hardware. Oh,
somebody
like
tweeted at me and said you can see a video. You can see it on its side. Hardware reveal trailer.
I don't think they showed it like being placed on its side. I think they showed it like as like a, you know, like panning and like a panning shot.
You see it. Yeah, they show it sideways, but do they show it laying on its side?
Yeah.
It'll have like a special mount for you to put it on the side. It seems like that top all like his fans all around it.
I mean, right now I have my console standing up on my desk.
Yeah.
But this looks bigger than the PS4 base model.
I don't know.
So, like, it's so weird.
I have a bunch of controllers here, so like they show size comparison for controllers. So it's
like, yeah, look, what, four controllers? It looks rounded on the. It looks rounded in all directions. It doesn't look like it's going to fit well on its side.
I mean, I kind of like the digital edition better just because of how symmetrical it looks.
I love that, but I
need discs.
I need discs,
yeah. I want to buy boxes. I get a discount on the boxes.
I think I need the disc. Yeah, the discless one's so much better. The discless one.
I almost always buy digital, but like I said, I do like having the option to be like, I'm going to play fucking Final Fantasy VII Remake 4 times. I'll save $20 on it. Like,
I didn't see it on its side at all in this montage.
I wonder how much all those extra peripherals are. Like the headphones, the media remote.
Headphone's gonna be a hundo, I'll tell you that right now.
Yeah.
How media remote. The controller.
Probably 60.
So.
Could be.
I'm gonna. It could be up to 70.
I think it's gonna be more than 60. I think definitely more than 60.
It could. Yeah, that. It could be 70. Because Nintendo got away with it. They're gonna be like, we can get away with it too. We got haptic feedback.
Yeah. At least $3.
At least $3,
at least
for
$3.
Sure.
It's true. At least $3.
Greg, I'm sorry. Mario Maker blew Warzone out of the water.
Yeah. All right.
I'll play tonight,
though.
It's
Saturday. Oh, yeah, you can do it tonight. I'm cool with that.
All right, I'll
tomorrow.
I'll also do Saturday. Oh, wait. Are you not? Are you guys going to be working Saturday?
Depends on how late we're staying out till.
Are you going to take a Warzone stream away from me on Saturday?
I hope we don't. If anything, I guess we'll have to see when Jerry gets home today. I don't think he's working tomorrow. So, get up before 8, we can do it for 9.
All right. Well, everybody, follow Lord Beardus on Twitch if you want to see Warzone probably tonight, because I'm not going to stream it.
Yeah, probably be great. A similar time, like 9. I'm not going to do it now. Sunburn. I need to tend to my burns.
Well, GG's, fam. GG's.
I think that was a very good reveal. That was a good, some good trailers we saw.
A lot of good games.
And man, I'm going to start looking in my couch cushions for that $3. So I can buy a PlayStation 5.
Captain Pika, thank you.
All right. I'll talk to you guys later.
All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Too far. I talked it back anymore. Give
how
me more.
How do I close this, this poll now?
I don't know. Goodbye.
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 Goodbye. Everybody's leaving me.
Maybe I'll hang out for a little bit.
Can I just straight up delete it? Archives or archive it? Play Mario Maker. I'm going to get some water first, though. Oh, also, goodbye, Wolf Den Vods. Hope you enjoyed.